TR Rehab. It's the middle of August, and a few people were asking me to do a walkthrough of the garden. I'm in no way claiming to be a professional. Most of this stuff I'm figuring out as I go, thanks to YouTube and Google. Here we have my string bean patch, maybe a week after I've done some serious pruning, and you'll see the flowers starting to come back now. I even have some little baby string beans on here. I have so far this year, and we're just midway through the season, gotten about 30 pounds of string beans off of this one bed. And from the way that they're coming back after this pruning, I'm almost sure that I'll see at least 60 pounds for the whole season. Some people find it interesting that when they ask me, well, what kind of string beans are you growing? And I'll tell them, I don't know. We do a lot of our grocery shopping at Sprouts, which is an all-organic grocery store. So I thought it'd be interesting to see if I can grow some of the fruits and vegetables that we're already eating. Here we have my sweet potato bed, and pretty much the same thing. I have no idea what kind of sweet potatoes these are. I bought these again from Sprouts and decided I wanted to see if they can grow. I started off with two potatoes, planted them in a 2-gallon flower pot. As the potatoes sprouted, the vines came off. I ended up with 12, and here we have my sweet potato bed. Here's another one of my favorites in the garden, Georgia collards. Now, the thing I like about these is they'll continue to grow all season long. If it gets too hot, they will bolt on you. But what I like to do is just keep plucking from the bottom leaves of each plant as opposed to getting one meal out of one plant. And these things will produce for you all year long. I planted these back in January. For the ones that bolted on me, I just pulled them out, threw them in the compost pile, planted new seeds, and we continue the growing process. We're in mid-August, and I'm starting to get ready for my fall gardening. So right here, I have 4 mini cabbages started. And then 3 weeks later, I put in another 4. 3 weeks after that, another 4. But succession planting makes so much sense once you get into it. Look at my poor zucchini plants. I have no idea what went wrong. We have been getting a lot of rain lately. I mean, literally every day we've been getting rain. I've done everything I could think of. I've looked at videos, Google, and I've had no success with zucchini squash. Here we have is what I believe is a squash bug. That could be the reason. I don't know. I got 2 zucchinis from 4 zucchini plants. My tomatoes are doing very well. Succession planting is the way to go. Each plant is producing at different times. Once again, I have no idea what kind of tomatoes they are. I gathered the seeds from these huge tomatoes we bought from Sprouts last year. These things get up to baseball size, with beautiful rich color. And I think that my fish fertilizer has a lot to do with that. I use the fish fertilizer 0-10-10 along with my eggshell and vinegar brew for calcium. And these things just look really good all season. Both tomatoes and peppers are subject to blossom end rot, so I feed them pretty much the same way. Again, the 0-10-10 is one of my go-to, and I also use the 5-1-1 fish fertilizer. Both are weekly feeds on different days of the week. The color on these fruit are so rich that it looks unreal. Once again, purchased from Sprouts grocery stores, all organic. And as with my tomatoes, I also feed my peppers my eggshell and vinegar brew, which creates pure calcium, and I dilute that 10-to-1 ratio and a good soil drenching. These 12 plants are ideal for a family of 4. Peppers don't last long on the shelf, so what we don't use when we're cooking, we'll freeze them and later on use them in smoothies. I had a 6-pack seedling tray back here on the rack that I was trying to grow some Roma tomato seeds in that never quite took off. And I think what happened was I took that tray, added it into some compost, and I planted this lavender plant right here. And voila, look what happened. Beautiful Roma tomatoes coming in. Interesting to see how well it's doing inside of this lavender pot. Again, seeds I gathered from Roma tomatoes we purchased from Sprouts grocery store. All organic. Last year, when I decided to try my hand at this gardening thing, I planted 12 cucumber plants in this bed. I had so many cucumbers, it was a job even trying to give them away. So this year, I decided to only do 4 plants, and I've had just the opposite results. Because with the rain that we've been having every day, the cucumbers are swelling up so fast. By the time they get into the 3 to 4 inch range, they're looking like baby watermelons. So what I did was I pulled all the old plants out, put new seeds in, except for this one where you see this large cucumber on it, and I'm starting over from scratch. Each cucumber plant's gonna have on average maybe 70% male flowers and 30% female flowers. Here are my navy beans and one of my favorites in the garden. True confessions, I never knew that navy beans were actually porkin' beans, or as we like to call them, baked beans. I have 16 plants in this raised bed, and next year I definitely think I'm gonna do at least 32 plants because I wanna have enough to feed a family four at least once a week and then store throughout the winter, and again, have that at least one meal of navy beans once a week. The pods start off a beautiful rich green, and then they start to turn a lighter green, and then they turn almost white, and from the white they turn into a brown French fry type tannish color, and that's when they're ready to be picked. And as you can see, I got these things growing all up and down the vine. You have flowers growing everywhere, which tells me that this is going to be a beautiful harvest, and it's going to take me all the way through until the cold months. My bamboo stakes are 6 feet tall, and they're draping way over the bamboo. Just gorgeous. Maybe a month ago, I had deer come through, and they took half of the tops off of all the navy beans and took some of them all the way down to the ground. So we'll walk around to the other side, you'll see where I actually had to start over from seed again, and I brought my insect nets out. Midsummer, seedlings are a delicacy for any type of insect. When the seedlings reach the top of the cage, that's when I'll remove them. I took this particular plant out the cage 3 days ago and it's doing pretty well, but I also sprayed some BT on it as a precaution. Because as soon as you take that cage off in the middle of the summer, you can guarantee the insects are on the way. Even with the cages over the seedlings, you're still gonna be battling insects. These plants are about 4 weeks old and well into their true leaves. So all we're gonna do is just go down and pluck off the first leaves and any other affected leaves, do a little visual inspection, and move on to the next seedling. This one has a little ways before reaching the top of the cage, so we're gonna leave it there for a little while longer. This one we're also gonna leave in the cage. This one's ready to come out of the cage, and I can tell just from first glance, the brown spots on it and the holes in the leaves, that we've had some type of infestation in here. And if we look around after going in and plucking off these first leaves, you see the one caterpillar stretched out there to the right of the leaf. And then you see all these black spots all over the leaf. And it's also some on the leaf that's under it. But those are baby caterpillars all clustered together. In 2 to 3 days, they'll destroy this seedling. So again, what we want to do is do a visual inspection of all the leaves to make sure that we have no more infestation on the seedling. And I'm most likely gonna put it back under the cage and allow it to recover from the attack, as well as the leaves being removed. And yes, gardening does require a bit of vigilance, but as with anything in life, you get out of it what you put in. And this is the part that I love. This is my golden raspberry, or yellow raspberry as some may refer to it. I'm gonna be moving this over into a whole separate bed where I have nothing but raspberries and strawberries. This beautiful little gem is Echinacea. I have these all throughout my herb garden. I'm gonna bring a few more of these back here from the herb garden because they're excellent in drawing in pollinators. I'll take a few of these leaves, grind them up, take a little apple cider vinegar, mix it in with it, let it sit for about 2 weeks, and you have one of the best cold remedies, flu remedies, arthritis remedies, inflammation remedies. I mean, it's just look up Echinacea plant. Not only is it a beautiful flower, it's a great boost for your immune system. Over here in the pots, I have quite a few starter plants. I have tomatoes, red raspberries that need to go into my berry bed, sweet potato slips, as well as lemon thyme. Out here, I have one of my two brown turkey figs that I'm going to be growing into a bush. Then you have my pink lemonade blueberry. I don't know how you get a pink and blueberry mixed together, but a pink lemonade blueberry. And out there you have a lemon tree that I put in last year, and it's doubled in size this year. So I'm hoping next year I'll start to bear some fruit. Here you have my emerald blueberry. Both the pink lemonade and the emerald I put in late spring of this year. So I don't know if it's gonna fruit going into the fall, but definitely next year I'm looking forward to having fruit. And here again is another one of my figs. This is the brown turkey also. I have two of those. And last but not least is my Santa Rosa plum tree. I grew white potatoes in a 20-gallon planter earlier this year. That went so well, I want to do a 4x12 raised bed just for my potatoes. Should be able to get 24 plants in that size bed. Well, this is my garden, my therapy, and I thank you for watching. Please subscribe and hit the like button if you want to see more videos like this. TR Rehab.